learning outcome. This module helps you to understand some basic concept like firm, industry and market, market structure, measurement of market structure, market power, market conduct and market performance. The price and output determination is an important entrepreneurial function in any market. Profit of the firm is affected by price, which is depending both on revenue and cost. Profit is nothing but excess revenue over cost, which always depends on volume of sales. Therefore, the aim of the entrepreneur is to find out the optimum combination of price and output, which offers the maximum profit to the firm. Therefore, the knowledge of market and market structure with which a firm operates is more helpful in price output decisions. Market in economics means a meeting place where buyers and sellers deal directly or indirectly. Market structures are different market forms based on the degree of competition prevailing in the market. Broadly, the market forms are classified into two types, such as A, perfectly competitive market, and B, imperfectly competitive market. Perfect competition means all the buyers and sellers in the market are aware of price of products. In a perfectly competitive market structure, there are large number of buyers and sellers. Products are homogeneous. There is free entry or exit. All the buyers and sellers in the market have perfect knowledge about the market conditions. There is perfect mobility of factors of production and complete absence of transportation cost. Any deviation from this market structure is known to economists as imperfectly competitive market structure. Let's look at some of the basic concepts. The concepts of firm, industry, market are important to know before knowing the measurement of market structure. These concepts are explained in the following section. Now, what is a firm? A firm is a unit owned by one or jointly by a few or many individuals which is engaged in productive activity of any kind for the sake of profit or some other well-defined aim. All those firms owned by private individuals in manufacturing, trade, and services aspire for profits. However, there is some other such as public companies where profit motivation is not the objective. What is an industry? Conventionally, industry refers to a group of firms producing a single homogeneous product and selling it in a common market. However, in practice, a single homogeneous product based industry is impossible. Most of the firms produce many outputs which may or may not be substitutable for each other. In this situation, the conventional definition of industry fails. A better approach to define the industry is a group of firms producing close substitute goods for a common group of buyers. In the terminology of the monopolistic competition, we are essentially talking about the product group as a substitute word for the industry. The competition among the firms as well as among their products is implicit here. It is not necessary that the substitute goods always come from the same industry. Two goods having similar end use may come from two different industries. For example, air conditioner and air coolers are used for cooling the room, but they cannot be taken together as output of one industry. The nature of these products is different. They are based on different technologies, so one cannot easily conceive them as outputs of different industries. Similarly, a firm producing, say, two different unsubstitutable goods need not be classified under only one industry. It may be classified under both the industry, but in what proportion is a matter of controversy. Classifying the firms on the basis of their principal products is a practice which is being followed at present. According to Wilson and Andrews, an individual business must be conceived as operating within an industry which consists of all businesses which operate processes of a sufficiently similar kind and possessing sufficiently similar backgrounds of experience and knowledge so that each of them could produce the particular commodity under consideration and would do so if sufficiently attractive. This is a much broader definition which may serve our purpose best. However, till we have to get a much precise definition of industry where technical aspects related to products and process are and process heterogeneity. Organizational heterogeneity and the institutional aspect of the industry are incorporated together. If we take the firms within an industry and their products as competing groups in the definition of industry, then what do we say about a monopoly firm having just one homogeneous product selling in the market? It is very much an industry. The point here is that it is difficult to define industry precisely. The definition depends more or less on the purpose of use of the industry. A clear demarcation of the boundaries of industries is very much needed since it is the industry which is the primary focus of the competitive forces. Its structure constrains the conduct and performance of the firms within it. What are markets? Broadly, defining a market is a place of a group of buyers and sellers where buyers demand and sellers supply the goods and services for exchange. Market is defined as a closely interrelated group of sellers and buyers for a commodity. The term is not equivalent to industry, since in the latter case, we will be looking only at the seller side of the market. By including the buyer side, the term becomes more comprehensive, connoting the composition of the buyers and the geographical location along with the industry. A heterogeneous group of closely substitute goods will have a market, but there may be markets within the market for every homogeneous good. Within the market, the good is treated as uniform. The edge of the market is defined by a very low or zero cross elasticity of demand between the good concerned and every other good. In practice, it may be difficult to define the precise boundary for a market. A market is said to be imperfect if there is lack of information about it. There are entry barriers to it, and the product is not uniform. Market structure, measurement, power, conduct, and performance. In industrial economies, market structure is the number of firms producing homogeneous products. It happens that the imperfectly competitive market structure is quite identical to the realistic market conditions. In such a market structure, monopolists, monopolistic competitors, and oligopolists exist and dominate the market conditions. Market structure is a function of the uniqueness of the products, barrier to entry, and scale economy. The more uniqueness of the product leads to the higher entry barrier. Similarly, the pricing power is largely depending upon the scale economy. A general trend is that most firms produce more than one product. Therefore, keeping in view these firms, it is more appropriate to classify market structure based upon the products being sold. In one extreme, many firms under perfect competition selling homogeneous products are price takers with zero pricing power. On another stream are the monopoly firms selling uniquely patented products who can exercise price discrimination. In between both these markets, monopolistic competition and oligopoly market structure falls. Figure 1 shows 5 major categories of market structures, which is based primarily on the product sold. In case of perfectly competitive market structure, the fixed cost is very low. From figure 1, it is observed that as we move from right to left, our fixed cost will increase, and in monopoly market structure, it becomes high. Same phenomena is also observed in case of entry barriers. When we move from right to left on entry barrier line. However, opposite phenomena is observed in case of firm line. Number of firms decline when we move from right to left, that is, from perfectly competitive market structure to monopoly on the firm line. All the above criteria are entirely depending upon the product produced by the firms. When we are moving from perfectly competitive market structure towards monopoly, the products become more and more unique, which determines the market structure. Thus, the elements of market structure include the following. A, the number and size distribution of firms. B, entry conditions. And C, the extent of differentiation. The main criteria that distinguish different markets structures from one another are A, the number and size of producers and consumers in the market, B, the type of goods and services being traded, and C, the degree to which information can flow freely. Taking the market as a complex body, we have to examine how its different constituents, such as sellers and buyers, are linked together. This we can specify in terms of organizational characteristics which determine the relations. A, of sellers in the market to each other, B, of buyers in the market to each other, C, of sellers to the buyers, and D, of sellers established in the market to the new potential firms which might enter the market. According to Bain, this means those characteristics of the organization of a market that seems to exercise a strategic influence on the nature of competition and pricing within the market. Market measurement. The main features of the market structure suggested by Bain, which are important to understand the concept precisely and to measure, are A, the degree of sellers' concentration, B, the degree of buyers' concentration, C, the degree of product differentiation, D, the condition of entry to the market. The degree of sellers' concentration shows the number and size of distribution of firms producing a particular commodity or types of commodity in the market. The degree of buyers' concentration shows the number and size distribution of buyers for the commodities in the market. The degree of product differentiation shows the difference in the product of different firms in the market. The condition of entry to the market shows the relative ease with which new firms can join the category of sellers in the market. Each of these four different dimensions or features of the market structure is important in determining the behavior of the firms, which is also affecting their performance as well as the performance of the industry as a whole. The number of sellers is a crucial variable determining the structure of the market. If there is only one firm, then we get the form of monopoly market. If there are two, then duopoly. If few, then oligopoly. And finally, if there are many, then we encounter with atomistic market. In each case, the process of output and price determination, as already mentioned, will be different. Similarly, how differentiated goods and the large number of sellers generate the conditions for monopolistic competition is another example showing the importance of the market structure. Looking at the absolute size of sellers as another feature of the market structure, there will be interesting problems to find how the larger one will be more efficient than the smaller one, or vice versa. When we take into account the size of distribution of the sellers in the market, we will have to find whether the concentrated industries are more efficient than the others. Similarly, the buyers' concentration in the market plays their own roles in the real-life situations. Market structure is a multidimensional concept. So it is not possible to measure it through a single variable. In practice, a set of variables related to different aspects of it are used simultaneously to measure the market structure. Let's look at the market power. In market structure, market power plays an important role. Market power is used to denote the degree of monopoly arising out of the various elements of the market structure. It is a relative term which gives the firm or a group of firms a degree of discretion in controlling the price, the output, and the nature of products that it sells. Within a high degree of market power, the firm will be an active entity in the business. In the situation of competition, the market power will be negligible. The discretion will be removed, which means prices moving down to the cost. The firm will be a passive entity in the market. Similarly, market conduct in many ways is an essential behavioral component of market structure. Market conduct is defined as a pattern of behavior that firms follow in adopting or adjusting to the market in which they operate to achieve the well-defined goal or goals. Given the market conditions and the goals to be pursued, a firm will be acting alone or jointly to decide about the price levels for the products, the types of products and their quantities, product design and quality standards, advertisements, etc. Also, the firm under such situation has to devise the ways for interactions, cross-adaptation, and coordination among the competing group of sellers in the market. All these are the elements of market conduct. Take, for example, a simple situation of two firm industry. Both the firms intend to maximize profit. How should they conduct their business for this? Naturally, given such conditions, we have to examine how the firms will be taking decisions about the prices, quantity of output, etc. in the market. They may ignore each other and pursue their objective independently. They may join together and share the total profits of the industry in some mutually arrived agreement, or they may be involved in the dirty games of competing with each other, such as indiscriminate price cuts, product disparagement, disturbing the supply line of raw materials of each other, bribing of the government officials, and so on. There may be more honorable tactics, such as product diversification, effective advertisement, and sales campaigns, and favorable credit terms to the customers. All these activities reflect the conduct of the firms in the market. Such activities can be extended from a two-firm industry to one which is having large number of competing sellers. The choice of the tactics or strategies is a better word, reflect the behavior of the firm in the given market situation. This is very important aspect in the organization of the firm. How such strategies are to be chalked out and how to implement them effectively is the task of the management. The entire process of reacting to the market situation in pursuit of the desired goal is called market conduct. Just like the firms, buyers of the industry may adopt some behavioral patterns reacting to the market situations. This will define the market conduct from their side. Consumerism, a social movement meant to protect the interests of the consumers, may be cited as the simplest example of the market conduct from the buyer's side. Monopsony and its behavior in the market is another one. Market performance. Market performance is the end result of the activities undertaken by the firms in pursuit of their goals. High profitability, high rate of growth of firm, increase in the sales, increase in the capital turnover, increase in the employment, etc., are some variables on the basis of which one can judge the market performance of the individual firms depending on their respective goals. For the society as a whole, the performance of an industry may be judged on the basis of its contribution in increasing the welfare of the masses. This is not easily measurable. For simplicity, we may take the stand that if the industry has generated satisfactory level of output of products at reasonably low prices, then it has contributed to the improvement of social welfare. We may also look at the performance of an industry through its ability to generate employment in the economy. Let us summarize what we have done in this module. In this module, we have discussed some basic concepts of firm, industry, and market. A firm is a unit owned by one or jointly by a few or many individuals which is engaged in the productive activity of any kind for the sake of profit or some other well-defined aim. Conventionally, industry refers to a group of firms producing a single homogeneous product and selling it in a common market. However, in practice, a single homogeneous product-based industry is impossible. Most of the firms produce many outputs which may or may not be substitutable for each other. In this situation, the conventional definition of the industry fails. A better approach to define the industry is a group of firms producing closely substitute goods for a common group of buyers. Broadly defining, a market is a place of a group of buyers and sellers where buyers demand and sellers supply the goods and services for exchange. Market structure is a number of firms producing homogeneous product. The imperfectly competitive market structure is quite identical to the realistic market conditions. In such a market structure, monopolists, monopolistic competitors, and oligopolists exist and dominate the market conditions. Market structure is a function of the uniqueness of the products, barrier to entry, and scale economy. To measure the market structure, we use the degree of seller's concentration, degree of buyer's concentration, degree of product differentiation, and the condition of entry to the market as a criteria. The degree of Senner's concentration shows the number and size distribution of firms producing a particular commodity or types of commodity in the market. The degree of buyer's concentration shows the number and size distribution of buyers for the commodities in the market. The degree of product differentiation shows the difference in the products of different firms in the market. The condition of entry to the market shows the relative ease with which new firms can join the category of sellers in the market. Market structure is a multidimensional concept, so it is not possible to measure it through a single variable. In practice, a set of variables related to different aspects of it are used simultaneously to measure the market structure. Market power is used to denote the degree of monopoly arising out of various elements of market structure. Market conduct is defined as the pattern of behavior that firms follow in adopting or adjusting to the market in which they operate to achieve the well-defined goal or goals. Market performance is the end result of the activities undertaken by the firms in pursuit of their goals. High profitability, high rate of growth of the firm, increase in the sales, increase in the capital turnover, increase in the employment, etc., are some variables on the basis of which one can judge the market performance of the individual firms depending on their respective goals.